Hi guys, it's Petrina, your go-to girl for learning how to make fit work in a crazy busy world. And this week's video is all for you science junkies like me out there who've been wondering about DNA testing. Specifically, 23andMe DNA testing. I'm gonna do a little quick unboxing and a review. I'm gonna show you what you can learn when you do a 23andMe test, both on the 23andMe platform, as well as some other cool online places to go to get to dig even deeper into what makes you you. So buckle up and put your geek hat on. Be warned, 23andMe testing is not cheap. You are going to pay $199 to get your kit, mail it back, and get all of your results. When you do go through 23andMe for testing, you're not only going to find out where your ancestors came from, you'll also find out if you're a carrier for certain inherited conditions, some other neat wellness reports, and just all sorts of goody-goody gumdrops that I'm going to show you later. In the meantime, let me show you what's in the box when you get it. Look at me getting my Vanna White on. So the process is, you pay the money, you wait for the kit. It takes usually, I think it took me like a week before I had it on my doorstep, and it's just in a small little box. And as you can see too, on the back of the box, it's already got your postage paid. So all you need to do after you're done collecting your saliva is put it back in the box and mail it back. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Now when you open your box, you're gonna see right away it's gonna prompt you to register your kit online, because you need to register before your kit even gets processed. So make sure you go ahead and do that before you mail it in. When you pop that out too, it's got all the instructions for how you're going to collect your spit when you do the test. And I will tell you too, it is a fair amount that you're gonna need to do, and you need to not eat or drink for, I think, like half an hour before you collect your saliva. It's really simple. All you need to do is like spit into this little funnel thing and you'll fill it up to the line. So it's gonna take you several minutes of clearing your mouth out to get it done. But once you're done, all you do is cap it off and a preservation fluid is gonna come out. And then you take the funnel off, put a little cap on it, pop it in this little plastic bag, put it back in your box, close it off, and mail it in. It's ridiculously easy to do. Once you mail it in, it usually takes anywhere from between 6 to 8 weeks for your tests to get processed, to get all your reports done. And of course, the excitement happens when your kits are done and you'll be able to view everything they've gleaned from your computer. So let's go take a look. All right, so here we are in the 23andMe platform. This is what you will see after you log in and you have all your results. This is the home screen. To get to the good stuff, you're gonna first click on reports from the top menu. And here is where you'll find all sorts of the different health and medical kind of information that you can find. The big one, of course, is the carrier status reports, which will tell you if you have any genetic variants you have that you could potentially pass on to your children. They offer 36 different types of carrier information. I got everything back totally fine except for MCAD deficiency, which is pretty rare. And that's very low blood sugar while fasting or under stress. When you scroll down, you'll see all the different carrier information you can learn. If you're someone who's interested in starting a family, this can be really valuable information and something you should definitely speak with a genetic counselor about if there is some variants detected. You'll also see there are ancestry reports, wellness reports, traits reports, and tutorials, which are very helpful when you're just getting started to kind of learn how to navigate the platform and also interpret the kind of information that you learned. If you want to skip ahead and just see all reports, you click on, of course, all reports to see all. And if you do choose the all reports, you can scroll down. You can learn all sorts of really fun stuff like muscle composition, facial features, physical characteristics, responses, taste and smell, haplogroups, which is really fascinating. And that can tell you where a small percentage of your ancestors came from thousands of years ago.
if you are a female using the 23andMe site, you're only going to be able to learn your maternal haplogroup. If you want to learn your paternal haplogroup, you'll have to have either a brother or your father get tested to learn what that is. You can also see how many variants you have in common with Neanderthals. I had quite a bit, as you can see. I have more Neanderthal variants than 98% of other 23andMe users. Explains a lot. There's also cool information on alcohol, flesh reactions, caffeine, lactose. And then to the very bottom, that is going to be all of those different carrier variant gene information. The big thing that people usually use reports like 23andMe or other DNA testing is ancestry composition. So if you want to see that, you click on view report. And with that, you'll see there's like color coded in the maps of where your ancestors came from based on your DNA. If you want to see all the populations and get a breakdown, you can do that. As you can see, I am mostly European, mostly Northwestern European to be specific. There's a little smidgen of East Asian, which was surprising to me. And also I'm a little teensy tiny bit Italian. So that can be really fascinating if you're someone who really wants to learn where your ancestors come from and, you know, what you are composed of. If you have a mom and dad that are willing to do 23andMe reports, you can connect them on the system and you can see how much of your composition was inherited from each of your parents, which is really neat. One of the big selling points for me in getting 23andMe was the ability to do these kinds of surveys so that I can contribute to research, which is really cool. There is a share and compare option where you can connect with family and friends and kind of compare your own DNA. As of now, January 2016, they only have 4 different wellness reports. I'm going to go in a little bit into other tools you can use, the raw DNA data that you get from 23andMe to get a little bit more detailed as to what your DNA possibly says about you health-wise. As you can see, there's info on muscle composition, the alcohol flush reaction, caffeine consumption, and lactose intolerance. For traits reports, there are 19 different as of, you know, now in January of 2016, where you can see different reports on facial features. And these will tell you your chances of having different versions of a trait based on specific genetic variants. Like for example, for the eyes, it's going to tell me that I'm likely to have light colored eyes based on my DNA. And then 97% of people who are genetically similar to me have blue, green, or light hazel eyes, and mine are like a bluish green. You'll get to see the percentage breakdown of what the genetic likelihood is with different colors, and also how it compares to other European ancestry customers. It's 4 different reports on hair, where they can guess at your hair color, the texture, and you know how much hair you probably had as a newborn. 3 different reports on physical characteristics, where you can learn your finger length and toe length ratio, and what kind of earwax you probably have based on your DNA type. 1 report on physical responses, and it's on like photic sneeze reflex. And the photic sneeze reflex is how likely you are to sneeze in the sun. As of now, there are 2 different reports you get on skin, and it'll be about skin pigmentation and freckles. And lastly, there'll be 3 reports on taste and smell, where you'll learn how well you are at detecting bitter tastes and sweet tastes, and if you can identify the smell of asparagus when you urinate, which hopefully this isn't TMI for you, but as you can see, I am 61% more likely to be able to smell the asparagus metabolite in my pee. And I can tell you that that is true. I am one of the 61%. Now, as you'll see for each of the different reports too, you can click on the scientific details tab and it will tell you a little bit more about how they arrived to certain conclusions based on statistics and the information that they've curated. And then the next section you can go to tinker around is the tool section. And again, with this one too, you can share and compare family data based on those who have allowed you to compare. You can also find genetic relatives to make connections with. And for that, you'd click on that and they're going to give you a list. And as you can see, mine has nearly 2,000 people who are potentially DNA relatives with me that are on 23andMe. As you'll see, too, some choose to remain anonymous, so you'll see no other information about them other than whether they're male or female and what percentage DNA you share in common and how many segments you share in common. Now, I've blurred out information for those who have shared their name with me just because I want to keep that private. But if you want to connect with someone on 23andMe, you can click on that person's name, even if they are anonymous, and you can send them a message through the 23andMe system. Now, this doesn't guarantee that you're going to actually get a response from people you attempt to connect with, but if you are using the system for ancestry purposes, this can be a really helpful tool in hammering down your family tree line. And as you'll see too, the system will guess whether or not you're second cousins, third cousins, it'll categorize. And if you want to narrow down and just see people who are potentially third cousins with you, you can narrow that down. If you like, you can share with your mother and father if they're linked up on 23andMe and try to figure out whether it's a maternal or paternal designation you have for that particular relative. You can also narrow it down based on grandparents, how many grandparents you share, birthplace, whether or not your grandparent was Ashkenazi Jewish. And I'll blank this out as well, but they're also, you can narrow it down based on the surname of the people who are coming up as connections with you. It's really fascinating. So also underneath the tools, you can actually go ahead and build your own family tree, and they've paired with MyHeritage.com. So if you're someone who's already using MyHeritage, you can just link it up that way or create a MyHeritage account through 23andMe to build a family tree that way. You can also, especially if you found out that you're a carrier of one of the variants, you can find a genetic counselor through 23andMe. There's also a forum section if you want to geek out with other 23andMe customers and talk about genetics and health and ancestry. And this one is the goldmine if you want to dig a little bit deeper with your DNA, both for ancestry and health-related purposes, and that is the raw data. You can actually click to browse it and see exactly which chromosome has which types of genes or SNPs within. Or you can just simply go ahead and download your data in its raw and interpreted format. And with this too, you can upload that data into different types of service providers to learn a little bit more. And that, in a nutshell, is what you can do in the toolkit. Under the research tab is where you can answer different questions and surveys that 23andMe will use for its own research. And it's really super cool. As you can see, I've contributed a lot to research. I think it's really neat that they're able to do that. If there's a topic or something that you're interested in that you're not seeing come up in the questions and the insights, you can actually give them feedback and make suggestions on different types of research they could do to learn a little bit more. And that's it. That is a little tour of 23andMe. And coming up next, I'm going to talk a little bit about more fun stuff you can do with your raw data.
And rather than go ahead and show you the different tools you can use using your raw data, I wanted to talk to you a little bit about them just because it can get a little bit overwhelming and confusing, and I didn't want to bog down this video with, you know, extra information. And the most useful and fascinating one, in my humble opinion, was Prometheus.com. Prometheus offers a dirt cheap, we're talking $5 way, where you can really dig deep on medical types of information relating to your DNA. And with Prometheus, you can learn about all sorts of certain health risks you may have. What Prometheus basically does is compare your raw DNA test data to information collected from all sorts of different peer-reviewed scientific journals and creates a personal report linking your DNA variations to the information published about them. The big con of Prometheus is it is difficult to use and understand. It can be so difficult, I may end up doing a little tutorial and overview of Prometheus. It is a ridiculously cool service, but one that I think can lead to unnecessary panic and distress when it comes to your DNA results, just because a certain clinical trial shows that a piece of your DNA may mean that you have an increased risk of certain cancers. does not necessarily mean that you're actually going to fall victim to those particular types of cancers. Fascinating stuff, and it's well worth the extra $5 you pay. Another cool resource you can try for absolutely free when it comes to interpreting your raw 23andMe data can be found at athletogen.com. And this one's really, it's very simple to use. You'll pull up the platform and there'll be like a little rainbow, and you can learn how your genes can influence power, speed, your vulnerability to injury, the way your body responds to training. You can also delve a little bit into sports psychology and learn how your brain's genetic framework can influence how well you perform under stress, your ability to focus, your motivation to train, and other behavioral tendencies. You can also get a little bit of dietary insight and see how your genetics can influence response to different types of diets, supplements, fats, and carbs. It's really fascinating stuff. It's pretty easy to read and easy to use, and it's totally free. And the third and final resource I've used with my raw 23andMe data was for ancestry purposes. If you have a really strong interest in genealogy, you may want to upload your results into gedmatch.com. This is a totally free resource. You can get certain extra tools if you make a donation, but you know, for the basic stuff you can get for totally free just by uploading your raw 23andMe results. If you're someone who's hardcore into genealogy and if you have a GEDCOM file, you can match that all up in there. I'm not too skilled on ancestry and genealogy, but GEDmatch is a really neat way. You can even find additional potential blood relatives to you. Another cool feature of GEDmatch is you can share and compare data with relatives even if they did not test with 23andMe, which is nice. You can use it to find out whether or not your parents are related. You can even have a little fun and see if it can predict your eye color based on your DNA. What do you think? Is it a match? So that's it. That's my quick little overview and review of what you can expect and what you get with 23andMe. I hope you found it useful. And again, if you want to check it out yourself, you can go to PetrinaHammFitness.com/23andMe to learn more. That's it for this week, friends. Take care and have a great week. Bye-bye.